at practice, I was thinking about this. Bitch, on the news, yeah, they see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause all of my life, training day and night, I'm preparing to fight for everyone, never leave. Crowds going insane, yeah, they screaming our name while we spraying champagne. Nothing nobody can say, cause today is the day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. Everybody count it out. Everybody up, now we back down. To all our pain and sweat was for this moment right now. All from different places, but we came with each other. We came together as a team, but we leaving as brothers. Standing next to one another while we hold up our colors.
I'm gonna look into the camera and tell my mama I love her. Cause
today is the day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world, all my blood, sweat, and grind goes all for this time.
Today is the day that I have always dreamed of. And forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world.
I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world, all my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time.
Today is the day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. And forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world.
I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world, all my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time.
Yeah. Hey guys, it's Pav. What it meant to be a Green Wave to me was being part of a family and a sisterhood. You know, sometimes we had the greatest of laughs and sometimes we fought, but at the end of the day, we still cared for each other and we still had each other's backs. And one of the toughest times for me was senior year. We were going into the section final game, and 2 days before that, my great grandpa died, and there was no place else that I'd rather be than on the field with my sisters. One of my favorite memories is, I guess, putting the first trophies in the case for the program, but that wasn't just for our team. That was for all the girls that played before us and all of our other sisters from the families before. So I guess one word that would describe the Green Wave to me is tradition, and just passing along all those things and wanting to play for the people ahead of us and wanting to play for all the legends of the team and the people that made the program. Good luck in your season, guys.
Have.
My name is Hannah Straw, and I played for the Green Wave girls varsity soccer team through my 9th through 12th grade year. I graduated in 2012. It was one of the best experiences throughout my entire high school career. I still think back to all the fun times that I had playing soccer with all my girlfriends, and it's just something that makes me smile. That was something that was so special. When I played, we won two section finals in advance to state, and then we were the runner-up section finals, so we didn't get to go to state. Those times were especially heartbreaking, I guess, but when we did make it to state, it's probably one of the greatest feelings ever to be able to accomplish one of those goals with all those people that you cared so much about and you worked so hard with. I still kind of get the goosebumps just thinking about it, because it was such a special time in our lives. When asked to describe varsity or Green Wave girls soccer in one word, I would definitely say family. We literally bonded as a team so well. We were a family. There's no other way to describe it. We did everything together. We cried together. We laughed together. We trained together. We, you know, went through many injuries together. We spent every waking minute together, from on the field, at school, spaghetti feeds after practice, in the bus. It was just, we cherished all the time that we had together, and to this day, I'm still not really certain how we all didn't get sick of each other. I guess through my personal experience, I went through a pretty significant injury. I broke a vertebrae in my back, and right before my senior year, so it was pretty tough coming back. A little bit nervous, wasn't sure if I'd, you know, be able to come back to my normal game of play and be able to do things. And I don't think without my team, with my family, I would have gotten through that injury. It was really tough. I wore a back brace every time I was on the field. I was just, you know, physically exhausted. Mentally, my game wasn't all there, and emotionally, I really wasn't there. I was the crier. You could definitely ask anyone on my team, but they pushed me, and somehow with them, I made it through, and I learned so much about teamwork, about hard work, and just about how important having a supportive team and family are. To this day, the girls that I played soccer with are my best friends. Unfortunately, now I live in Bismarck, so that's why I'm doing this video alone, because they are all in separate directions. But we still talk on a daily, weekly basis, and when we get together, it's one of the best times. We have so much fun together, and they are truly my best friends, even after meeting, you know, tons of people in college. If I had to give any of you guys any words of advice, it'd just be to cherish every moment. I still feel like I'm a freshman walking onto the St. Cloud State field playing my first section final game, and I was totally, totally overwhelmed and so nervous, and I get goosebumps again thinking about it. And now here I am, a college graduate, working full-time, starting to pay off my student loans, and actually being an adult. And if I could go back and play soccer a few more years with my best friends, I'd give anything. So cherish these traditions that we are trying to bring back to Green Wave soccer. Enjoy the time with your teammates, because who knows, they could end up being your best friends for life. Play like champions, that's something we always used to say. Work hard and make sure you have fun, because really that's what it's all about. Don't stress yourself out too much, because in the end, everything will be worth it and you'll be super glad you did it. So I wish you all the luck this season, and go Green Wave.
Hey guys, for those of you that don't know who I am, my name is Francie. I had the opportunity to play several years on the varsity team, which was just such an awesome experience. I learned so much from playing with older girls, younger girls, same age level girls. And one sentence that I would describe Green Wave soccer would just be pushing it to the limit, working hard all the time. I remember sitting in school and just being like, oh, I just want to go play soccer with my friends, work hard, scrimmage, team Halloween with those orange pennies versus no pennies. Just all the fun stuff you can do with your friends, and just working out while you're working out. But being a leader, team building was awesome, going on the trips. My favorite thing about Green Wave soccer was playing the night games under the lights with just so many people in the stands. I think we had more fans than the football team. In fact, I know we were more successful because we lit it up. The reasons we were so successful is because our team had heart. We loved the game. We had passion for the game. We all played our role. We all knew what needed to be done each game. We would prep for each game. We'd watch film, look up stuff on the other team, get their info on what they were good at, what their weaknesses were. I just hope that this Green Wave program can get back to where it was and continue to be awesome, so one day my kids can be a Green Wave soccer player and just love it.
Hi girls, from experiencing Green Wave soccer both as a player and as a coach, one word comes to mind. That is integrity. Don't forget to always have each other's back through the good and the bad. Some of my best high school memories came with my soccer teammates, who became my best friends. Good luck this season.
Hi, my name is Anna Holting. I am a Green Wave soccer alum watching the current Green Wave soccer. That's you guys. I graduated in 2012 as a senior. One tradition that I really love about Green Wave soccer is the green ball that we all pass around. You guys still have that. Hopefully no one lost it yet. I almost lost it once. But anyway, so I want you guys to know the symbolism behind that. It's as you're all in your circle holding arms and whatnot, you guys pass it around for your first touch. And as you pass it around, each person gets a touch on it, and it just basically gets your first jitters out of the way. And to me, it really symbolizes the fact that everyone is going to be involved in the game, whether you're on the bench for most of it, whether you only get a couple touches, whether you're scoring a hat trick that game. Everyone's going to be equally involved in the game, and you're all working together for the end common goal of a win, essentially. Another tradition that I really love is the team sleepovers during beginning of season. They get pretty wild. We tried forking Bina's yard one time. Not sure if she knew that was us, but sorry, Bina. It was a fail, but it was fun. It's fun to hang out and get to know each other outside of the soccer also. I mean, you're with each other all the time at school, but it's just another fun thing to do. My eyes are watering, sorry. What else do I have to talk about? One of my favorite memories, that was that. Tradition was the ball. Oh! A word, I don't have a script, sorry. One word that describes Green Wave soccer to me is family. I know I talked about that when I came and talked to you guys last week, but it's so true. these girls will be your best friends for the rest of your lives, whether you're in the same city or not. I still talk to all my girls. We have a group message that we're texting in all the time, and they're some of my best friends, so really take to heart everything. All the time that you're going to spend with these girls and the coaches and the younger girls and older girls and all that other stuff, because they'll be some of your best friends forever, so keep that in mind. And another slogan, play like champions, because we want the championships back, right? Okay.
One mistake is all it will take. We'll go down in history.
I would say one of the biggest traditions about Green Wave Soccer would definitely be being a family. One thing that's being a family is hard to find, especially when you go to play for different teams or even go on to play college soccer. You kind of find out it's just not the same, and you don't exactly have the same bond or the same chemistry. Playing Green Wave Soccer, you basically all grew up together, all go to the same high school, you play other sports together, so you have that special bond, plus you play soccer together, so it's just something special that you don't exactly find other places. Another tradition I would say would just be playing for each other, especially in those big games against those rivals like Bemidji or even just Crookston, Moorhead. Those games that you really need everyone to come together so you guys can do the best you can, and especially playing on the field at home under the lights, something that is super special, and it's kind of like your own moment and you're with each other in it. And that's just something that I truly remember, and that's just something I think of when I hear Green Wave Soccer, just be playing for each other, especially just have everyone come together with their strengths to beat those big games.
Down in history, remember me for centuries.
I'm Jenna Wiss.
And I'm Sydney Bowen, and we're the class of 2012.
First of all, we want to say congratulations to all you girls that are here at the luncheon today.
Woo-hoo!
Those of you that are returning, congratulations. And those of you that made it, this is your first year.
Way to go!
We want to say that we're behind you guys 100% throughout your season. We always have been. That's just part of being an alumni. You're always supporting the girls, no matter what. You're once a Green Wave, always a Green Wave. Three.
Okay, so my one word that I'd say to describe Green Wave Soccer would be character. We are taught to be better soccer players, but we're also taught to be better people in general. As in, we're all supposed to respect our teammates, our coaches, the officials, at least most of us, besides Anna, who got like seven yellow cards? I don't know. But in general, we're taught to be respectful and respect one another, and I for sure became a better person because of it.
Oh, it definitely built our character 100%.
Yeah, so character.
Being pushed every day. I think my word would have to be tradition. Everybody always talks about the tradition of the program and the traditions that you do, but those traditions carry on with you. Like, every day or every home game, we'd start out in the cafeteria and we'd stand in front of the trophy case. Okay, so maybe they may have redone the school. But we'd stand in front of the trophy case, we'd hold hands, and you'd send the squeeze around. And you'd send the squeeze
Can't
around.
See it, but
you'd have to focus on the squeeze while still focusing on Bina's words, but don't mess up the squeeze or you mess up everything.
Yeah, and listen to Bina, because if you don't, you'll hear it again.
No. And like Danny and Jenna had said, the pinky thing, like walking out, we looked so confident and we carried ourselves so well as a team, and we'd start out doing the V before the game. So it's just all these different traditions that we had to do that just made us...
That we liked to do.
Yeah. That just made us look like a family and made us look like a team that
we, like each other.
We needed to be beat.
Woo!
Tell me. show you them.
My name is Jenna Perrault. What was your favorite memory of Green Wave Soccer?
My favorite memory of Green Wave Soccer was spending probably 70% of my life in the fall with my teammates and not hating it. And also winning and going to state and being the most dominant team in Section 8A soccer.
What is one word that you would describe Green Wave Soccer?
One word that I would use to describe Green Wave Soccer is family. We're such a tight-knit group, and that's still true to this day. I've lived with several of them since we graduated, and they're still my best friends. If you ask me who I'm closest to, it's all the people that were on my soccer team. And people think that's really weird. I think it's the greatest thing in the world. I love it.
Okay, on a serious note, we are normal.
We're normal. Yeah.
And we have
normal
friends.
Voices.
We have other friends besides
this, but
and other seniors on our team. But we just want to say good luck this year. Go to state.
Woo!
That'd be really cool. It's been a while.
Yes, and make the best of everything, every awful practice or running drill that Bina makes you do. Or,
what are those called when you...
Gassers.
Yes.
You'll learn. Make them learn, Bina. Make them learn. Make them know.
Tryouts. Tryouts. You're probably already done with tryouts.
How about the Green Wave Shuttle? Did you do that one? Tell them about that one, Bina.
I'm just kidding. But, on a real, good luck. We are cheering for you guys.
No matter we love what. You. I don't even know you.
And Green Wave Soccer is the best. You should be honored.
Living the dream.
I still wear the team. We
still wear the color.
Like champions, please.
Fat.
Represent.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, peace.
Okay, so that little was our little skit. So when we would walk into at a home game or any game, we'd get a partner, hold pinkies, and walk in. We look really badass, but we were smiling, but we usually look badass.
Focused.
And then the cheer, I hope you guys still do that cheer. That was our, everyone gets in a circle
for the game and we and yell and jump and
gets really pumped up, so.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it now, for reals.
Good afternoon, future EGF Section Championships of 2016. My name is Alicia Erickson, and I graduated in 2009. I was number 11 representing the Green Wave team. I wanted to share with you guys some of my favorite memories from when I played on the Green Wave girls soccer team.
I love those spaghetti feeds. Who doesn't like free food besides spaghetti, for sure?
I liked representing our school under the lights. Those were the best games, playing at 7 p.m. Everybody went to the games. It was super cool to watch. We always killed Crookston, so you have to kill Crookston this year, which I know you will because you're way better than them. I liked playing at Hillcrest because Hillcrest was like the Hogwarts school. It's really cool if you haven't been there yet. It'll remind you of Hogwarts.
And how can I possibly forget? What the fuck? when you play Walker, you have to say that and take a picture at the top of the hill with your pants down. But of course, you have to have your spandex on. You can't be showing everybody your soccer booties. And I, fun fact, started my very first varsity soccer game in a shootout in a section championship game against DL, and we lost. Ended my senior year in a shootout against St. Cloud Apollo, and we lost. So don't leave out the legacy that I did of losing on a shootout start to finish. So practice your shootouts. That's the main purpose of this, that story. When I think of EGF girls Green Wave soccer, I think of blood, sweat, and tears. Blood, well, because Grace Herndon one day got a bloody nose because it was dry out. And two, sweat, because running around and doing all those drills, you sweat. Unless you're like me and have a heat stroke twice. But besides the fact. And tears, because even if Hannah Strauss says she was the crier of the team, I am the original crier of the team. I proudly represent that. So, congratulations on making the varsity team. That's first of all, congratulations. Your hard work is starting to pay off, but this is just the start of your legacy. Whatever you do, don't let the ball drop the ground. Play like championships and always reach for the stars. Good luck on your season, ladies, and I can't wait to watch you guys win.
All I have to say is,
reach for the stars.
Hey guys, Chelsea Grassel, 2011 alumni here. When it comes to picking memories, it's very hard to pick one or two to talk about. Of course, we have those two section championships, the one we won in the shootout in St. Cloud, and the other one that we had a great opportunity, the one on our own field, that was pretty cool. But we did a lot of things off the field together, whether it was on the bus, just singing, having a good time, to the skits we would put on in the hotel trips, going out to Blue Moose after games. Those are all pretty special things that we still talk about and cherish to this day. When it comes to choosing a couple words to describe this program, obviously family, tradition, hard work, success are all big ones. When you guys step onto that field, you have a target put on your back, and that's because of everybody who has come into this program and played before you, and none of us will apologize for that. We worked hard to put Green Wave Soccer on the map, and we hope that you guys can keep the tradition going. And we're all here supporting you, cheering you on, no matter where we are in life, whether it's coming to the games or just even reading newspaper articles, different things like that. We still support you, and we're still a part of this family that we like to keep an eye on the program. So when you go out onto that field, you're living the dream, as I like to say. You get to put on your cleats, play a game you love with some of your closest friends, and make some memories that you're going to cherish forever. So when you do put on those cleats, remember you're playing for your school, you're playing for each other, you're playing for all of that have come before you. So enjoy it, embrace it, and live the dream.
First time in 4 years, I'm guessing, right? Mecca?
Yes.
Anyways, we were not gonna let that happen. So here we are.
Here we are.
Playing together.
For each other.
Yes. With Chelsea's butt cat.
Yes. Not my butt cat.
Oh,
Chelsea Warren's.
Stay there.
Well, to our fellow classmates, we're the best clique ever.
Kidding!
And Jacqueline, I really just want to let you know, all these years, after all these years, I let that tongue play soccer goal in.
Whatever!
I let it in!
No,
I let it in!
No.
I let it in!
You, no!
You looked like you needed a confidence boost that day, so I was just like, you know,
here's what
I see Miss Sumker in her future.
Oh,
I'm just gonna let this goal in.
That had nothing to do with it.
And that's what I did.
This is what happened. Chelsea Grassel, I shot a goal. With the 18, maybe a little bit off the 18.
No, it was not for the 18. She
was
a breakaway.
It was not a breakaway. Oh, was it a breakaway?
It was a breakaway.
Oh. Anyways, it was something like that. And I shot it with my left foot, and it was rolling literally 1 to 2 miles per hour, and Chelsea dove but she dove too short and it rolled in. And it was one of the most easy goal I've ever scored.
But I let it happen.
Ever.
And you know what?
Like, ever.
I let it happen.
Easiest goal.
Okay, but anyways.
Like scoring on a knockable.
Stronger. I need you to hurry up, man, 'cause I can't.